In this tutorial, we're going to take a look at how to quickly and efficiently manage your files inside of FlashFXP. As you can see, I have already established a connection into my remote server. Those files are listed on the right-hand side of my screen. On the left-hand side, I can see the contents of my mydomain.com folder, which is located on my desktop. This folder contains no files, therefore this part of the screen for the time being appears empty. You can create new folders simply by right-clicking on an empty space and select Make Folder. I'm going to give this folder a name such as Images. You can also right-click on an empty portion of that panel and select New File, give the file a name, and create a brand new empty file. As you create this file, your default text editor will open up and allow you to type in the contents for that file. Let's type in some basic HTML now. We'll go ahead and save this file and close the window. You can transfer files between your local directory and your remote FTP server simply by dragging and dropping. Here, I will drag and drop this test.html file into the remote server. This dialog is letting me know that I already have a test.html file on the server, and it's asking me whether or not I want to overwrite this file. I'm going to select yes by pressing on this overwrite button. I can also drag and drop files from the remote server into the local folder by dragging and dropping, the same way I did before. If you right-click on any of the files on the remote server, you will have additional options, such as the ability to change the file permissions. In this example, I'm going to change the file permissions so that the owner of this file can read, write, and execute it. The public can only read and execute it, and groups can read, write, and execute. This gives us a permission settings of 775. I will now press the OK button to confirm my changes, and the file permissions have been applied to that file. Congratulations, you now know how to manage files inside of FlashFXP.